Hello, my name is Brenda, and welcome to one of our expert educator series offerings. I'm going to talk to you about foam rollers. I'm going to call it a foam roller quick fix in 15 minutes. So you can get a foam roller at the rec center at the front desk. You can also order it online. OPTP is the brand that we like because they last the longest. You can get them so that they're nice and firm. The black ones are the pros. They last longer. They don't get dents in them. Just also want to show you, I get a small one for myself to take when I travel. Fits really easy in my suitcase or my backpack. So that works out well if I'm traveling for a long time and I know I want to use my foam roller. So the foam roller, what it does is it helps stretch our muscles, helps lengthen and release some of the fascia, the tightness. You've probably heard of trigger points, and those are sore spots. Basically, the muscles are not sliding and gliding as they should. So this helps stretch muscles, release the trigger points, release the fascia. So the fascia, you can also, I like people to think of it as a spider web. So when our fascia gets tight, it's restrictive with the blood flow and it's all bunched up together. And so when we release the fascia, we soften it and the cobwebs get spread out. The spider webs, they get spread out. And then our muscles feel better and they work better. So let's go through some basics. I just want to give you, again, a 15 quick fixer. So get the foam roller out and gonna make it so it's the length of our spine. So we're gonna sit on the edge of it, and then you can hold on to the ground to get down where you want to be. Now want your head on it. So make sure that your head's on it. So if some of our few much taller individuals, 6'4", 6'5", have a hard time getting their head and their tailbone on it. So your feet can be wide to make sure you feel secure, or they can be a little narrower to challenge your balance. And all we're going to do is we're going to rock side to side. So we're going to let that foam roller go outside our spine, side to side. And as we do these movements, some spots you may go, oh, wow, that's a little sore there. I didn't realize it. And you may not feel anything at all. So either way, you're getting something out of it. If you want to, again, make it harder for your core so you don't fall off the foam roller, you can put your arms across your chest and bring your feet a little narrower. If you fall off, don't worry, you don't have far to go. And then we're just going to come back center. Now what we're going to do is call reaching round, so like we're hugging a tree, a big old tree, and then we're going to retract our shoulder blades, squeeze. Think about pinching the foam roller with the shoulder blade. So we're going to reach and round, retract, and squeeze. So again, you may feel something on the outside of your spine, maybe one side more than the other. Now, where I feel it is more when I retract and squeeze than what I do when I reach and round. But again, we're all tight in different spots. And again, if you don't feel anything, don't worry. You're still getting something out of it. Let's do one more. Reach and round, retract and squeeze. And then just go ahead and exit off your foam roller. So now we're going to turn it perpendicular with our spine. And we're going to put it on our bottom, right below our bottom rib, okay? And we're going to keep our tailbone anchored on the floor. And all we're going to do, arms across the chest, or you can put hands behind the head, as long as we don't yank on the head. And then we're just going to slide our rear end on the ground. And then we're going to slide it back. So you walk with the feet. If you're new to foam rolling, sometimes it takes you a little while to figure out how to maneuver the foam roller. If your shirt gets stuck like that, you just pull it down and start to roll again. So you can count your rolls. You can just do it, as long as you want. I encourage a good 10 rolls. So then do one more, and again, you'll move with it. And don't worry about that. And then come back center. You can hold on to the ends to come up to seated. And now we're going to go ahead and do it with our bottom elevated. Put it at the low part of our back. Again, our bottom is off the ground. And arms across your chest, and then we're going to walk it up. Again, if your shirt gets stuck, just grab it, yank it down to the top part of our shoulder blades, not on the neck, and then we're going to walk it back out. So another bonus I always like to tell people when you use the foam roller is not only are you also stretching the muscles and releasing the fascia, you get a little core in here because you have to hold yourself up.
That's a little more than you want. Put your bottom back on the ground and just drag it again. Again, right above our tailbone to right above the shoulder blades, but avoid the neck. And then when you're ready, come on down. So that's good for our back. So now let's do our hamstrings, the back of our thigh. So you're going to put it right above the knee joint. We're going to right to the base of the glutes. So hands can be on the ground, or I should say will be on the ground. Bottom can be on the ground, and you're just going to roll back and forth. So depending upon your leg length, how long of a roll you get. And you can go in and out with your leg. If you need a little more pressure, you can elevate your bottom off the ground. So with continued use, consistent use, weekly use, you get to where your muscles get looser and you can handle a little more pressure. If you still need even more, you stack, okay? You cross one leg over the other. And again, that puts more weight. So again, you might find some sticky spots. You want to just kind of hang out there and relax and breathe into it because you're like, that feels so good. Again, you can go right up the belly of the hamstring right in the middle, or you can go a little to the outside, which is called the lateral, or the medial to the inside. So again, good 10 roll up and down, and then we want to switch legs. So again, bottom down, right above the knee joint to right below the glute, what we call the gluteal fold, right at the base of the glutes. If you need more pressure, bottom off the ground. If you need even more, stack. And you can do all three as it gets warmed up. I like to use my foam roller when I'm watching TV, watching comedy. Definitely before I go work out, I spend maybe just a few minutes on it, especially my back, before I go out for a run or go for a bike ride. And then come on down. So let's go ahead, while we're in this position, we're going to do our calves. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to go right above the ankle to right below the knee joint. So or I should say, yeah, right below the knee joint, not above it. So bottom on the ground. So again, always think of that. Bottom on the ground gives you less pressure. And again, more pressure is not better. If you have to make an ugly face as you do your foam rolling, you've got too much pressure on it. So support yourself more. Either put your bottom on the ground and drag it. If you need more pressure, again, bottom up. And again, you can roll in and out on the calf, medial and lateral. So again, medial's towards the midline of the body. Lateral is to the outside. And then if you need even more, you stack. You can stack and drag your bottom or pick it up. And don't forget to breathe. And then we're going to go and do the other leg, the other calf. So, again, right above the ankle joint to right below the knee. Sometimes we find one leg is a little tighter than the other. Don't worry about it. Just be aware of it. And then if you need more, bottom up. And then if you needed more, stack. Bottom down or bottom up. Again, don't forget to breathe. All right, nice job. Now we're going to come to our quads, the front part of our thighs. This one always seems to be a little awkward, in my opinion, to get used to. It's the hardest to figure out how to move on it. So we're going to go right below the crease of like think about underwear line, and then right above the knee joint. All right, so we don't want to go over the hip bone. We don't want to go over the knee joint itself. So you can just lay on it. Most people like to put the outside leg kind of like a frog because it gives them a little bit more control, and then they come down to their forearms. And then they go up and down. So you like walk it out, walk it in. So right above the knee joint to right by the hip crease. Again, you can wiggle the leg in and out. You might find a little bit more stickier spots in one place than the other. Remember, it's okay to just hang out where you feel that nice stretch, where you feel a,
a sticky point, a trigger point, and that's where you're real tight. And then by chance, if you need more, and I will let you know very few people need more on their quads, you can put the other leg astride and go up and down, or you can stack. And I'm not for sure if I'll be able to stack today. We'll see. Oh, I am. So, yay. So, again, most people can't stack for their quads. It's just a little too much. So, again, about 10 strides up and down. And then we'll change legs. Put the left thigh on it. Make your frog with your right leg. And then hip crease to right above knee joint. Out and in. Or up and down, I should say. And then if you need more, you're still straddling, but your right leg is extended. So you've got more weight on the left thigh. Or if you need even more, you're going to stack. Don't forget to breathe. So again, foam roller, 15-minute fix. And let's do one more. Nice job. So I encourage you, if you don't already have a foam roller, you go get one. Again, Rec Center, you can go optp.com and order one online. The other thing that I wanted to point out is, even if you don't do everything, if you only just do your back or you just do your hamstrings or your calves, you're going to get something out of it. You may pick a different part every day. And also keep it out so that it's in your way in your home, so that you remember to use it and get more benefit from it. So again, foam roller, 15-minute fix. I hope you like it. Feel free to give us feedback, and thank you.